Hello fellow tankers, bonjour amis tankistes. In this video, I will present you two disputed and quite nice gameplays, really, on this Advance to the Rhine map, which is one of my favorite maps in the game. And the reason for that is that it's a map which works very well in arcade, in RB, in low BR, in top BR. It's a map which actually works in all mode and BR. The second reason why I like it is that this map is a triangular map in the sense that the three caps have a triangular configuration. And as I have already mentioned on the main tutorial for this map, which obviously I advise you to consult, but also on the tutorials and the gameplays for the jungle map or for the Sands of Sinai map, these triangular maps are actually the most interesting for me in the game, and I wish that Gajin actually produce more maps with this configuration. And the reason why they are very interesting is that at any time during the battle, you have to think whether you want to concentrate on A or concentrate on attacking, for instance, the enemy cap. And what happens is that very often you have a stalemate between B and C, so in that case you have to control A to win. But sometimes you have one team which is very, very present on A, and in that case, that means that you will have ultimately to control B and C to win, because ultimately, at the end, to win a game, you need, in general, at least two caps. So I really refer you to my main tutorial. This map is actually much more complicated than people actually imagine. And I have already presented quite a few gameplays played from the north side, and I realized that I had very few gameplays from the south side. So in this video, you will find two very nice gameplays from the south side. So in this first gameplay, I'm playing my German lineup at BR 6.3, starting with this Tiger 2P. You notice that while going to A, I prefer to use this road, which is much safer than coming from this road where you can be sniped from there. Let me mention that, as you can see, a large fraction of our team is going in this area. And if you consult my main tutorial, I will explain you why fighting in this area is essentially useless. At least to try to control A. The only interest would be just to spawn kill the opponent. But honestly, I'm absolutely convinced that's not how you win this game at all. While many players are fighting there, the enemy will have obviously all opportunity to control B, C, and in fact A, because from the west of A you cannot put pressure on A very efficiently. So here the first goal is to clean the neighborhood of A, at least the west side, the east side of A. So let me mention that I am top BR. Very often I show you gameplays where I'm actually up-tiered, that is playing against tanks of higher BR than mine. But let me mention that at 6.3, 6.3 is a very nice BR. And very often at 6.3, you are either top BR or in a mild up tier. And even at 7.3, honestly, there is no tanks that you cannot kill. The IS-3 would be probably the only tank which is a bit difficult to kill. So, as you can see now, I'm actually pushing toward B. And I have shown you already many gameplays played from the north side where I'm pushing towards sea using essentially the north of this main road. So here you have essentially the same where you will this time exploit the south of this road. So again, being a top BR, you have to take responsibility. Sometimes I see that Tiger 2P, which is top BR and which is camping far away from where the battle actually happens, when you are top BR, you have to take responsibility. Here, you see that my plan to go to B is momentarily stopped by the fact that because we had so many people around A, and too many people around A, the enemy team had indeed the good idea to push towards C and essentially abandoning A for a moment. And so I'm coming in the park to help defend the sea and retake sea. So here there is this M4A2. I don't have any very good angle of view, and my priority is obviously this Tiger 2P, but obviously I'm a bit careful of this M4A2. I ultimately decide to fire a few smoke shells to be sure that this M4A2 cannot shoot at me very easily. And now I'm going for this M4A2 while my squad mate has helped eliminating the last tanks which were on sea. As you can see on A, most of the team is fighting on the west part of A and is actually losing A, which is a bit absurd. Again, from this west part you cannot control A, and if you have good players on A, I can tell you that recapturing A against good players is not easy. So that losing A just because you decided to push to the enemy spawn is a bit absurd again. So now I'm going back to my plan to control B, but there are actually quite a few tanks around B, so I'm deciding to trying to intercept them. Now I'm seeing a very dangerous enemy in a very short moment. That's more or less why I'm really thinking about what to do here. It's because there is this SU-100P which is in a quite annoying position on my right. And I still have this M4 on my left, so I don't want to die stupidly killed by this M4. Here I'm a bit slow to shoot at the jumbo, and I decide to shoot this SU-108P, and I'm a bit disappointed not to have been able to kill it. Obviously, since Gaijin has removed essentially hull break, light vehicles are extremely annoying and very hard to kill, to one shot. That's the case for instance for BMPs, for the Beglet Panzer and this SU-100P. And let me mention that at this point I have 14 nuke points, and I wanted to have 15 by killing this SU-100, but unfortunately a bit clumsy and he kills me, and I'm not even succeeding in killing him. And unfortunately, I failed. Let me mention that I had already a free nuke, but I never saved a game by nuking the enemy, and most of the kills that I did were in the enemy spawn in storms. And so far, I've seen also some squad mates or some other players doing nukes, but generally always in a one battle. And I really want to have a nuke in a battle where the battle would have been lost without the nuke. And I'll make a video if I meet that, but so far it didn't happen. So at this point, I will stop the gameplay. I will respawn, but I will unfortunately not see another enemy. And unfortunately, our team will even capture B ultimately, so that I will not be able to earn another nuke point. I remind you that you need 15 nuke points to launch a nuke, which generally you need typically, depending on what's happening. I don't exactly. A kill gives you one nuke point, and a few other stuff give you nuke points. And honestly, I didn't really understand what actually it does. So now I will present you a very disputed and very stressful, I remember when I played it, gameplay is this time in TopVR. And as you will see, the gameplay will be very similar. And that's really something that I like with this map. So this time I am playing my TopVR British lineup, starting with this Challenger 2F. Which I am finishing to spade. It's almost spaded, and it's actually much better than I anticipated. And for instance, the shell is pretty good, and the armor does the job until you don't bounce on the Panther, which will track you, or until you're not showing your lower hull. In that case, you can be one shot by essentially any tank. So as you will see, gameplay will be quite epic, essentially in the second part of the gameplay, quite stressful, I remember, during the battle, and I think you will understand why. But in this in the beginning of this battle, let me put my personal view. I actually decide to do essentially the same move that I did with my Tiger, really showing that the gameplay on this map doesn't depend on the tier or the BR. And really, coming from the south of this street is extremely powerful, whatever the BR and whatever the game mode, arcade or RB, for instance. And obviously, let me mention from the other side, you can do similar moves by coming along this road in the north of this road to attack C from A. So here, I'm taking a bit too much time to kill this T90A. And I realize you don't see them all on the map, but that there are actually quite a lot of people left in this area. And I'm actually a bit slow to realize that this T90A is here. He wrecks me, he's killed by one of my squad mates, but unfortunately, I don't have time to react, and actually my tank is all broken, and so I die. So I am respawning in my Challenger 2, which is not as powerful as the 2F, especially the shell, but which is not too bad. And here is the interesting part of the gameplay, where you will see heroic defense of A. As you can see on the map, my squad mate is completely surrounded on A, where there is, to my last count, at least 8 tanks around A. And my goal is first to prevent to the enemy to decap A, because honestly, when you have a lot of enemies or good players on A, it's very, very, very difficult to retake A. Here, this T62, which has nothing to do at this BR, is a bit naive. As you can see, I'm really surrounded from almost everywhere. And unfortunately, my thing, my squadmate will die. But I am shot by this Leclerc, and which makes the mistake, obviously, not to finish me. And here, I have to be very thankful to an ally on my right, who actually saves my butt. Mr. Yulu FR, probably a French guy. And so while I'm repairing, I'm showing on the map and with my machine gun that there is an enemy behind the wall, but this ally is wrecked by the T-80, and obviously I don't let him die. He saved my butt. I'm trying to do the same for him. And obviously, in battle, don't forget that War Thunder is actually a team game, and that when someone helps you, you should help help this person in return. But not only that, don't hesitate to take some risks, reasonable risks, to help your teammates. When you save someone, it's one more gun to fight the enemy. Here, I'm waiting for this SRV 1-to-1 to shoot, and I really advise you, obviously, whatever the BR, to rush an enemy between his shots. And unfortunately, my last ally on A dies. So I know I have a guy behind me, but there is a guy here climbing on the top. Okay, it's just a Leopard 1, but a Leopard 1 with the APDS, which are very powerful now, can kill me easily. Here I'm surrounded by bombs, and still I have to kill this Leopard to F4. I'm wrecked by the bomb, but miraculously survive and kill this Leopard to F4. And I think you can now understand how stressful was this quite heroic defense of A. And at this point, first I wanted to breathe a bit. Now realizing that there are not many enemies around A, and also seeing that my team was probably about to capture B. So I'm really thinking in between keeping holding A or pushing a bit to have one more kill. And now I see really my team approaching B, so I'm going for the second option. But obviously I will never take hopefully never take a risk to lose a game just for having one more game. Sometimes I accept to be extremely passive if it's just to hold a cap for a few more seconds. And obviously I advise you to do the same. So I'm killing this T-72 premium, which was doing I don't know what, and ultimately a nice game, hopefully, that you will appreciate along with the previous gameplay. And hopefully, which will lead you to subscribe if you didn't do it yet, and fire a few likes to do this video and others on this channel when you enjoy them. See you on the battlefield. À bientôt sur le champ de bataille.